all of you. So in this chapter we have started, and in exercise 12 we have discussed till question number 9. So in today's video we will discuss the remaining questions. So in question number 11, in a triangle ABC, P is the midpoint of side. P is the midpoint of side BC. Okay, so P is the midpoint of side BC. A line through P and parallel to CA. A line through P and parallel to CA meets AB at Q. So this is Q. And a line through Q and parallel to BC. That means a line through Q and parallel to BC meets median AP at, so median is AP, so that line meets AP at point R. So this is R. Prove that AP equal to 2R and BC equal to QR. Okay, so what is given in this question? Let's write the given things. Given is P is midpoint of BC, it is given, and PQ is parallel to AC. What else is given? Let this is PQRS, then QS is parallel to, or we can say QR is parallel to BC is given. And one very important thing is given, that is AP is a median. Okay, this is also given, that AP is a median. Now what we have to prove? We have to prove let's write AP equal to 2R. AP equal to 2AR. Okay, so we have to prove AP equal to 2AR. Now how we can prove this? That means, first of all, what we have to prove? AP is 2R means R should be the midpoint of AP. Then we can automatically prove. So let's prove it. So it is given that P is the midpoint and this PQ is parallel to AC. So in triangle which triangle we take? ABP, P is midpoint of BC So in triangle ABC, P is midpoint of BC and PQ is parallel to AC. So that will give us, again it is a case of the converse, that is Q is midpoint of AB and PQ is half of AC. So we can write it as midpoint, converse of midpoint theorem. Now, so this becomes a midpoint. Now which triangle we will take? Again we will take a triangle ABP. So in triangle ABP, we know that Q is midpoint of AB, that we have just proved. Also, QR is parallel to BC. It is already given here. So we can say that R is midpoint of AP, again by converse of midpoint theorem. Now R becomes the midpoint of AP. That means AR equal to RP equal to twice AR. AR is equals to RP equal to half of AP. So AP equal to 2 AR. So this is our first proof. Then we have to prove that BC equal to 4 QR. So from here what we will get? We will get QR equal to half of BC. QR equal to half of From here we can write QR equal to half of BP again. So here I am writing QR equal to half of BP, this we know, but BP is equals to half of BC. Why? Because P is the midpoint of BC. So let it be 1, let it be 2. From 1 and 2, QR equal to 1 by 4 of BC, or we can say that BC equal to 4 QR. Okay, let's see question number 13. So in this it is given, in a triangle ABC, AD is a median. So we know that a median is a line segment from one vertex, it is dropped on the other side, it will bisect that side. That means if AD is the median, that means D is the midpoint of BC. And E is the midpoint of this median, that is AE equal to ED. These two things are given. So we have to prove that AC equal to 3 times of AF. Okay, so what we are going to do, we will draw BG parallel to BF. Okay, so like this, we are drawing a line which is parallel to BF. Now since this line is parallel to BF, let it be G. So in triangle BCF, B is midpoint of BC, that we already knew. B is the midpoint of BC, and BG is parallel to BF. This is our construction. So what it will give? It means G is midpoint of FC, or FG equal to GC. Okay, by converse of midpoint theorem. So this is the converse of midpoint theorem. So So these two parts become equal to each other now, FG equal to GC. Now, again, one more triangle we have to take. Which triangle? In triangle ADG. So in triangle ADG, this is the midpoint E and EF is parallel to DG that we have already taken. So we will write E is midpoint of AD. It is already given that E is the midpoint of AD. And what else is given? BG is parallel to EF. Okay. Since this is a straight line, so DG is parallel to BF means DG is also parallel to EF. So that means F is midpoint of AG. Again by CMPT. Or we can write, AF equal to FG. So this is our first and this is our second. So from 1 and 2, FG equal to GC equal to AF. So these three are equal to each other. And since these all parts are now equal to each other, so we can say that it is equals to 1 by 3 of AC. And see what we have to prove. AC equal to 3F. So we can say that AC equal to 3AF. Hence, okay, so again we have used the converse of the midpoint theorem. So in triangle ABC, this is triangle ABC. AD is the median. Again, it is given that AD is the median. So these two parts are equal. And DE drawn parallel to side BA. So this we are drawing parallel to side BA. Meets AC at E. So we have to prove, we have to show that BE is also a median. So it is a similar type of question that we have just solved. So let's join BE. Now, in order to prove that what given AD is median. So that means B is midpoint, it is given, and BE is parallel to AB. These two things are given. So what we have to prove? To prove is BE is a median. Okay, now in order to prove that BE is a median, actually we need to prove that E is the midpoint of AC. So again, we will try to prove that E is the midpoint of AC. And how we are going to prove? See, in triangle ABC, D is the midpoint, is midpoint of BC, this we know, and BE is parallel to AB. So that means E is midpoint of AC by CMPT. And since E is the midpoint of AC, so we can say that BE is median of AC. will be called as the median. So hence, okay. Then in question number 16, so let's see question number 16, figure will be almost same. This is question number 16 and it will be like this. E is the midpoint of median AD. So this is our median AD, and in this E is the midpoint, that is AE equal to ED, it is given, and BE produced meets AC at Q. So when I produced BE, it meets AC at Q. So we have to prove BE is to EQ equal to 3:1. Okay. So we have to prove BE is to EQ equal to 3:1. So again, what we are going to do? So proof we will start. And we will draw BG parallel to BQ. Okay, BG parallel to BQ. So in triangle ABC, D is the midpoint of BC. And DG is parallel to BQ. So that will give us G is midpoint of QC, and DG is equals to half of EQ. Okay, sorry, BG equal to half of BQ. Then in triangle, next we will take in triangle ADG, E is midpoint of AD and EQ is parallel to DG. So that will give us EQ equal to half of DG. Okay, so this is our first and this is our second. Now we are going to substitute the value of DG here. So I will get from 1 and 2, okay, we have to eliminate DG. So EQ will be equal to half of, and what is DG? Half of BQ. So you will get PQ equal to 1 by 4 BQ. Okay, or you can write BQ equal to 4 PQ. Now, what is BQ? BQ is BE plus EQ. So, we will write BE plus EQ equal to 4 EQ. So, you will get BE equal to 4 EQ minus EQ. And in the last, we get BE equal to 3 EQ. So, finally, what we need? BE is 2 EQ. So, when you take EQ here, you will get 3, that is BE equal is to EQ is 3 is to 1. Hence, proved. Okay, so this is the end of this exercise, first exercise. Then we will discuss equal intercept theorem in the next video. Thank you.